The suppose you could say, oh dear Catherine, this is quite accurate. Yes, when it comes to snuggle time, I must say I do enjoy the warmth of another person. Especially on the cold nights of winter. It is a cold night tonight. That, and the fact that I think I know that you really I just want to say again that everything that happened is not your fault, little fledgling. It's really not. Our minds can do some interesting things, especially at night in the silence. Everything can seem so magnified and loud. And guilt. Guilt starts to creep in. As soon as you close your eyes. It's true. This I know quite well. Guilt, that is. Oh, it's okay. It's alright. There is one thing you should know. What happens and what is said in snuggle time stays strictly in snuggle time. That is the only rule. You are free to say whatever you want. I will not repeat it again. Unless you want me to. And I expect you to do the same. But sister Catherine, well, she made it out to be that I am the instigator. She does enjoy these night sessions. She is indeed sometimes so troubled. I love her so much, but she really does take on the world Ah, world, I suppose. She is the yin to my yang, and where I have no guilt, she will take it on for the both of us. I guess that's just the way she is. I couldn't be without her. And now we have you. And I enjoy the dynamic that you bring. It's okay. It's alright. Oh. If I'm honest, I was having trouble sleeping, do you? Aside from the fact that it's freezing cold, it's so cold. Oh. She will be joining us. Oh yes, Catherine. No, it's not a psychic. No, she didn't tell me. I just know. I know my sister so well. Oh yeah, she'll be here soon enough. I'd give it another, let's see, another 5 minutes. She'll be here. Let's try and look surprised. She does enjoy snuggle time too. Yes, she was right. But she likes it. Ah, the music, yes, I do prefer. Sometimes in the night, it's an old house, you see, and these walls, there's so much reverberation. I just think the music sometimes helps the silence, you know. If it's bothering you, I can turn it down. Okay, I'll tell you what, when Catherine gets here, we'll get her to turn it down before she jumps in. Getting sleepy. Good. It's good. It's alright. You can close your eyes. I'll just talk until you fall asleep. It's okay. You don't remember what happened? Well, alright. I didn't want to bother you with that, but I'll explain. So, I suppose you probably remember getting ready for the dinner. Yeah. Well, it kind of took a turn after the third course. We had a delicious meal, but Catherine is such a good cook. Oh, I love my sister's cooking. So, she cooked us this delicious meal. And you met Bethany. Yes. Bethany is one of our human donors. And everything was going so well. We were on a third course. It was the fourth course, of course, that took a turn for the worse. You see, the fourth course, of course, was Sia. The blood. And while you had eaten, it was far too soon. It was too soon to expose you like that. We blame ourselves. I should have known. I had a similar incident myself when I was young, like you, when I was newly turned. I know we said it's a difficult time, especially in the beginning, but nothing could quite explain the hunger. So, dear Bethany, offered a few drops of her blood, and unfortunately this exposure, should we say, was too much, and but that's why you have us, and we made sure that the unpleasant experience didn't last. Bethany is safe, and she's fine, and we can be sure that you are your vampire teeth are fully functional, and it might be hard to believe, but she's been through things like this before, with fledglings. So, she's fine. You are fine. Everyone is safe. It was just not a pleasant experience, that's all. And we don't want you to feel bad. That these things happen. Take it as a lesson. Catherine would be so surprised to hear me say that. But it's true. Everything good and bad are lessons. I surely have had many of both. Also, maybe the bad. And you can only learn from them. Your eyes. Listen, you can hear her. Yeah, she's coming. Catherine, darling.
Yes, it is.
Would you mind turning down the music a little?
Of course not.
Our fledgling is feeling quite sleepy now.
Okay.
Thank you. Hurry up and get in. It's getting so cold.
It is very cold.
Come on. Come. Talking about anything, have we?
Right.
I mean, we spoke briefly about the incident.
Oh, I see. I'm so sorry for everything that happened.
It's not okay. I told you should come.
So you were talking about me. I really do feel terrible about what happened. It's all my fault. It really was.
It was both our faults, Catherine.
Well,
you were not to blame. I did
arrange the dinner.
These things simply happen.
Yes, I guess they do, but I feel responsible.
Yes. Whenever you feel the need, just close your eyes and drift off.
She's right.
Please. Yeah. Get some sleep. You'll need the rest.
Oh, sounds like you both need the rest, Isis. You should get the rest, yes. What are the plans tomorrow?
Well, tomorrow I was thinking we could do some sparring.
Oh, yes. That'd be nice.
I do like to keep fit.
Of course.
And we do want to make sure that you can protect yourself. Not
true.
That you need to, I mean. Nobody would survive trying to attack you when we're around.
Yes.
They'd have to get through me.
Not before they get through me.
Exactly.
You'll always be safe around us. I'll be sure of
that. They'd be deceived. Catherine can be quiet.
What? Quite what?
She can be quite vicious.
He's a little mad. I do like a good sparring session, indeed.
So yes, we'll do some sparring.
Okay, sounds good. And then maybe some shopping. There's a few things to get.
Alright.
List.
I might have to accompany you on that shopping trip.
I think we'll be fine.
I don't.
Why not?
We don't want you to come back with a whole shop, so...
Oh my God.
It would be wise to have someone with a sensible head.
Oh my God, I don't know what you're talking about.
A fledgling doesn't know just how bad your habit is.
Just leave them out of this.
You do have a problem.
I do not have a problem.
I believe they call it a shopaholic.
Oh, please. You're making this up, Odessa. It's not that
bad. They have groups. Is there a Shopaholic Anonymous?
No.
I'm sure they can join a group. I've said this before.
Gosh. She never listens to me. I think we should get her to go. Exaggerating and dramatic.
I'm not being dramatic.
Yes, you are. And it's really not that bad.
You haven't seen her wardrobe, have you? Her wardrobe.
Please.
Let's talk about Catherine's wardrobe.
It's both our wardrobes, actually. This entity.
Oh, please.
This entity is bigger than my room. She has a whole room full of clothes.
Oh my God.
And shoes and bags. It's and whatever else Catherine can get her hands on. She is obsessed. She gets mad when I decide to help her out, because there is no way that you would wear all those clothes. Even in this century, Catherine, it's absolutely ridiculous.
She adds to that collection.
Why do I need clothes when you have several shops worth?
She has her own clothes with her own closet. She's picking on me.
I am not picking on you, my dear sister.
Yes, you are.
It's a good job that I happen to like your taste.
I'm just jealous. Mm.
And we're the same size after all. I'm just doing what makes sense.
Yeah, well, maybe I should stop you from using my wardrobe then.
As Catherine was saying.
As I was saying, yes, you will.
Of course. You can purchase what you need.
And we will arrange the finances for you. You will have your own card and allowance, of course.
Arranges that side of things.
Yes, we'll get you everything you need in terms of money.
Exactly.
Accounts.
You don't need to ask our permission.
You're free to
build. We just ask that you let us know when you leave and give us an idea of when you'll be back.
Exactly. You are, of course, perfectly free to come and go as you please. This is not a prison. This is
exactly
your home. Yeah.
You look so tired. I'm getting quite sleepy myself, Catherine.
Should have got some sleep.
Snuggles.
Snuggles indeed.
You're so warm.
I could just eat you up.
Something about new fledglings. It's so comforting.
It's true. I can just
sit to that fresh feeling
you radiate.
Such
just intoxicating, isn't it? Mm.
Such need.
It's true.
It's quite intoxicating, actually.
I think you sound quite maternal, Odessa.
You will get used to that. Smells.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. You can smell an emotion.
There is so much to learn. But you have plenty of time.
It's true.
Please don't feel like you have to rush or learn.
We will teach you everything you need
in good time. We'll train you. If there's any lesson to have learned from the dinner,
take your time.
That is that we really don't have to rush anything.
Okay. And we are here for you.
Take one step at a time. And whenever you're ready. You really do have the best bed.
It's the warmest room.
For sure.
Mm. Why do you think us being in this bed is making it more comfortable?
I hope you're warm, dear fledgling. I know.
We
should get some sleep. I'd be so tired. We won't be able to wake up. Are you a morning person? Actually,
yes,
I am a morning person, believe it or not.
Yes.
My dear Catherine, however, she's not so much.
No,
it's strange, but
oh, she likes to lie in, which is fine.
I've never been good.
I like to rise with the sun.
Had it since she was a human.
It's unusual, I know. It's a habit I've never been able to shake, even as a vampire.
It's true.
Yeah,
it's a strange one as well.
Of course, I do try to sleep. Sleep during the day. Because that's what we have to do. Especially now. Well, for me and Catherine, it's that.
When you get as old as we are,
that we had to adjust to. But
it's okay.
That doesn't stop me from wanting to be awake during the day.
And of course, you can do.
Sometimes a struggle.
Do what you need. Oh, I do, fledgling.
So.
I think
do whatever works for you.
I think
we can adjust. You really don't need to switch your hours. There's no need to sleep in the day yet.
Of course.
As I said, you'll be fine to continue your routine.
Especially when you go back to work.
It's important. I know.
You'll still be able to be in the sun all the day, so
try and get you back to a routine that works.
Please don't worry about that. It's just us. Just us and being centuries and centuries old. Come on. Let's get some sleep.
Sleep well, dear.